You may not know what will happen. And therefore, the time comes you can Plans are in most cases blown, whereas the personal plans are They want a long-term and short-term. Depending on the circumstances in your environment, you can decide to have a long-term plan or short-term plan. In modern times, we have medium-term plan as well. And this long-term plan depends again based on what you want. It goes beyond 3 years. That's how we use our time 7 years. For example, there's a plan in Canada and you can have a 7-year development plan. It is said, this one can be called a plan to stay. But I want to have a short-term plan. It can come 1 year or less. It may mean that the specific thing that we want to achieve is a plan for that short term. But in most cases, we need to go for a medium-term plan, much for our 2 years. And it is because of the fact that the government is so stable, it's still on the table, that medium-term plan enables them to review their activities within a short term so that they don't lose anything that might happen to them if it's a long-term plan. Now, we have specific, and we have specific and international plans. What is specific? It means that it leaves no room for ambiguity in the is what is supposed to be, what according to it. But then if I also follow a direction plan, which means that it gives you the general guidelines and people are allowed to use certain specific plans to, or certain measures to determine how the plans do work. So that direction plans give you an overall framework. And you can have direction plan, you can find certain things that you can do that you are going to achieve your own. Then we have a single-use plan and then a standard plan. A single-use plan is used in order to decide to meet a specific need in a unique situation. While standard plans are ongoing plans that provide guidance for activities performed repeatedly. For example, you can have your studies, you can have a standard plan, and it can help you to determine how you study from first year to the final year or even within a certain period. But what is specific use plan? Very different examination time. These are going to do mistakes. And so once the time is over, that plan is abandoned, and then you go back to your normal self. And how do we develop plans? There are certain things that we need to consider when we want to develop plans. At the international level, we need to also look at the uncertainty, uncertainty, and then the line of future, for the line of future politics, what we intend to do in the future. This short term is not going to work. As I don't believe, we're going to look at the relationship between the managers and the organization and the type of plan. And you can see that in most cases, what is at an investment level, top managers will do the plan and then it is given to the lower level managers. While the lower level is based on the strategic plan, they will create a process. Some of these are given. And then they have their own operational plans that suit their specific needs. So this is a diagram depicting how the distinction between the organization and the organization level process. And we have a review of the number of security. We have said that the least environment is highly unstable. And so depending on the type of level of treatment from the game, it enables you to determine whether you have a specific plan or from a general and international plan. And by the way, what about the cases? That plan needs to be flexible. If the environment is uncertain, you are not sure of what the environment is going to be like in the future. Then the plan must be flexible so that any time there is any other kind of environment, you will be able to revise the plan to suit the changing needs of the environment. And then the commitment concept. And so the plan that you draw should be able to meet your commitment to the organization or what you intend to do and how far you are committed to what you intend to do. If you think that you are going to be able to commit to a certain plan of 5 years, depend if you are not committed, 5 years is too long for you. So it depends on approaches in prayer, we have a traditional top-down approach and an all-inclusive approach. The traditional top-down approach is when top-level management will be telling you what should be done, and then again, we'll bring it down to the other levels of implementation. Remember, they need to consult or sit down with the former planning department where the department is responsible for planning, and they sit down, they determine it, and they come down to the lower level. As a one of this is done, they do it and make sure that it suits the needs of the organization. But sometimes, because it is from the top manager, they do not have a better understanding of what is happening at the various levels. And therefore, it becomes a problem to complete or to be applied that particular plan that comes from that came from the top level. Sometimes because of the fact that it comes from the top, because the top managers know every part of the organization is captured, it becomes full of information and it becomes difficult for them to read and understand. And so what managers need to do is that they need to go straight to the point, they need to plan to understand what they want to achieve is what they have planned for. And not just to use the final judgment, which is not flexible. They say that the thing will be not planned, which is not planned to do. Then at the audience of this, in this one, all the members, all the various parts put their heads together, and then they meet. So all the various parts, they meet at their respective level, develop them, all to the management level, and then it is fine tuned to be implemented. Now, is planning sacrosanct? No. So when we plan, sometimes it can be so solved that we don't even want to change, especially if our plan is set in stone. It becomes difficult for modifications to play what they do at writing. And then, we can use forward planning all the time to replace creativity and intuition. It is that a we need people who might be able to think on that. We think outside of that. And so if we have formal plans and it is rigid, we will try to prevent people who are creative, who are innovative to bring out their ideas. And so yes, planning is good, but it might be good for people to be intuitive, to be creative, or it comes in to help the organization to achieve this objective. Then planning also holds the mindset of attention to this condition, not tomorrow's survival. Yes, we may have a project, we want to focus on this. But then how do we tackle tomorrow's, what we need, what will come up tomorrow? Once we plan, we will forget about what happens tomorrow because the thing that we have set or put in place is so good that we do not even think about the other thing, but then focus on what we have done and then on what we do. Former plan, the other way was successful, it will lead to failure. We are speaking about escalation of commitment. You might think that we have planned and therefore it is that it's useful, it is good. And so all the time we focus on that particular plan. We may not think of reviewing because the government has changed. If these things happen, the planning might lead us to failure. And so that plan is not just enough. Plan is not enough. We need to be creative, we need to be innovative. Understand the environment so that once the plan is there, you use your creativity, your ingenuity, and other things to help the plan work for you to be able to achieve your strategic objectives. Now, we have contemporary issues in planning. But if you are planning the dynamic environment, what do you need to do? The plan is specific, but first of all, we are speaking about that, and then you need to understand the plan. Plan an ongoing process, it's not an event. That is said, I have finished, and therefore I'm going to fold my hands. So it's an ongoing process. We need to set a plan every day, we need to find a plan of the environment. And then once there is a new communication, you modify it to suit the changing needs of the environment. That's why I say that we change. are the persistent in the environment. Even though we are saying that there's a need for education to see the change, the alarming needs of the environment, we need to pause, we need to persist. We not need to abandon your plan if you're good for your work. No. And this might come. Be quiet if you come. But we need to persist. But these are the plans we have drawn. It is that they can only carefully cut out of them. And so we need to ensure it is carried to the level. Even though that is an a time will come when we may need to modify, to see the changing way. But that's before that you have funded the entire community. And then we need to also allow the lower level employees to set rules and develop that because of the general skills at all levels. These days and days, you don't have to think that management is the only people who are wise, who know what they want to do. Remember the poor worker. Now the parents that came to school also knows something about the best information. He is going to implement the plan that you have set. And therefore, his inputs, his ideas are also very important when it comes to the planning process. If they are involved, they form the plan, they form the goals, and therefore, one of these things are goals are set by themselves and they are set. They work towards it. And then they are able to achieve the plan. Or achieve the plan that you have set for them. Now, as a manager, you need to capitalize on that score and the other skill. What's the other skill? It is that mechanism of that method of where the managers are able to look, see through, how an assessment of the environment, and especially the life events that are like in part of the organization. Once you do have the power of the understanding, you are able to manage things. Both from within or from outside. Now, once you do provide an understanding, you are able to anticipate changes and plan for those changes that may come. But you didn't take care of when you plan. And if you want to do an understanding properly, it enables you to factor into your plan that things are likely to happen. So when they come, they don't surprise you. Now, as I have said, planning. Once you have different plan and then you have the plan, it's not plan. So once you plan, you need to implement the plan. And then to the later, you persist. And once you persist, all things will be good. You are likely to achieve